Here we go, the Division II Grand Final at the Central Regional Championships here in Racine, Wisconsin, as the Dallas Magpies and the White Jumpers taking on the Columbus Jackaroos wearing the blue. There was a bit of a jumper clash, Jackaroos are wearing the USAFL branded jumpers. And we are underway here as the Dallas with some possession, with a possessional advantage in the early going, but it's been kicked out on the full. So Columbus will have an opportunity to come back now. Both teams winning both of their games earlier to get to this final. Oh, deflected there. It's picked up by Mark McClure. There's a pass over, and now they'll kick that one through as Preet had it for Columbus. Clyde Simpson is in there. He was taken down by John Dobbs for Dallas, and it'll be a boundary throw and some incidental contact. Clyde Simpson, the captain of this team, who spent some time in Rainbow, Australia last year playing his footy over there, and he actually made a presentation at the annual general meeting last year telling what a great experience that was. One of many Americans that have gone over to play over there.
They're part of the player exchange organized by Tony Fairhead. He was incredibly successful and has actually, in more ways than one, Clyde, he met a young Aussie girl.
Ooh.
And they've since got engaged.
Wow. So good for you, Clyde.
Clyde's not going to be staying in the US much longer.
Well, you know what? For an Aussie girl, I probably wouldn't do it either. I'm just saying in general, I'm happily married to a nice Virginian girl. But in any event, the ball is out on that far side and it's out of bounds for a boundary throw.
Fortunately, we don't have scorers, and the score on the opposite side there at the Real Racine scoreboard is still the score from the previous game.
Well, that's why we have iPhone apps. The ball comes back into play up on that far sideline. Pushed forward by the Jacks, and then it's paddled out of bounds, and it'll be a boundary throw-in. Dallas, of course, winning earlier their two games. I'm trying to remember what the pools were now. I've seen so many games today.
Some light drizzle here at
That score.
Score soccer complex. Hopefully it doesn't get any worse.
Yeah, the clouds seem to be pretty thin, and the skies are blue. And the skies were a little gray for the Magpies there, but they handball it around. Great job. They kick it out in front. And it's a great, and it's a goal.
No,
it's actually, it's a behind by Zorka. Looked like it was in, but it did came back. So Dallas gets the first score of the match, 1-0, 3 minutes in.
Chet Ride now kicks out for Columbus.
Yep, that's Philip Preet. Chet Ridenour, the founder of this team. It's a bit of a sandwich there, and now moving on. Oh, able to push him off there was Dobbs. And then gets over, and the ball goes out of bounds.
Number two,
buddy.
Number two.
Yeah, that's a gap. There. Things getting a little. Whoop. Duck. Paddled forward again by McClure, who's also on the national team. That should have been a throw, and it wasn't. Storer got it. And now, good job by Clyde Simpson to force the turnover. And then the mark goes directly across. Oh yeah, forgot about that. So straight out in front, and the mark is taken. Oh. No, you don't. Now we're gonna shake a little bit as we go up here. Mark down in front, the kick, and that's going to travel through for a behind. So 2-0 on the Real Racine scoreboard.
choice for right now to be the man kicking out. He's done two in a row, number three, so he's doing well. But you'd think he'd be one of the targets he'd be looking for.
Looking for Simpson. Nope, just over him, but it was touched before it went out of play. Also in there was Corey Colvin for Dallas. Boundary throw in, comes straight back in. I don't think we have boundary umpires either. Maybe we do. Oh. Coming in, and there's a good mark in defense. And a kick by 24 I don't have here, and the mark is taken. Yeah, it's Kyle Bass. And here's the mark taken by Adam Peterson. And now it comes back the other direction for Dallas. It's a one-on-one contest off hands, but cleared out by Columbus. He slipped down. The grass starting to get a little bit slick with that dribble. Handballs it over, just over the head of Preet. And we have a whistle. Wow, he was all the way on the other side of the field. And that's a yellow card. So the USAFL, for those of you who may be familiar with AFL footy or footy back in Australia, the USAFL has a card system similar to soccer. Actually, it's more similar to rugby. So that's a sin bin. And Dennis, you may want to clarify me on the rules. I think that's a 15-minute sending off.
And he can be replaced.
Yes, so they don't lose a man. It's not like a red card. If it was a red card, then he's sent off, and we'll get that for you. Meanwhile, Columbus now trying to take advantage. It's up on that far side over there.
The yellow card, I think it may actually be the rest of the half.
Yeah.
Fairly... 15 minutes is basically going to take up the quarter or the half anyway.
Anish Mystery with it, and we have it's going to be a free kick. So it goes to number 22. That's Ryan Munter. Munter just joined the team last week, and he actually wanted us to say hi to his parents back in Perth, Australia. So hello to you, Mr. and Mrs. Munter, back in Perth. Your son just hit a really good kick inside 50, and the ball is... ball is batted around down there. It comes out. There's a shot for goal, but it's gone off for a minor score. So it's 2-1 now. I don't know if the weather is having any sort of effect on this. It's there's really hasn't been too many clean passages of play. But it's 2-1, all behinds, 7.5 minutes into this one. And in case anyone was worried, we do now have a scorekeeper on the Real Racine scoreboard directly across from us. So here we go. The ball gets kicked back into play over the head and controlled there. And he's held up. A great job by Tom Jornter, who was able to get in there on Alec Dooley. In the end, it's a ball up, and it's punched forward by Zorka, I believe. Controlled by Steve Ramo, and Jortner was able to get it away. That's touched. Charging on for it is Storer, but instead it was Chet Ridenour who got to it. And it's over for a throw-in. Chet Ridenour, member of the U.S. Revolution team previously. He went to the International Cup in 2011 and 2014. I don't know what that was, Chet. Maybe you'll have to explain it to us. Meanwhile, there's a high tackle, and it's going to be a free kick to Dallas.
Yeah, that's a costly mistake there by Chet. I guess he didn't want to grab hold of the ball out of the ruck, because if you do and you get tackled straight away, it's holding the ball.
So, yep.
Probably very conscious of that.
Storer's free kick is on the way. And it's going to be a goal. Started out left, but corrected itself. And that's the first major score of the game. Dallas goes to 1-2-8. Columbus 1 point as we near the midway point of this first half.
We do have someone now over there fixing the scoreboard for us. So.
And for those
of the young lady.
For those of you scoring at home, I did happen to mention it a couple of minutes ago. But to be fair, Dennis is spending a lot of time bringing you these pictures. So I guess I can't. Plus, he's the president of the league, so I can't complain about it too much. All right. Here comes Dallas again. That one goes inside 50. It skips through. A good job. I believe that was Ramo back there with the headband. And then finally picked up and cleared away. But the mark is taken. A good job by Jordan Edmonds. But in the end, it's Derek Epperson who will take the mark and will try to add to the lead. So off of one step, and that sails wide, 1 point. 9-1 is the score on the Real Racine scoreboard. 10.5 minutes gone, first half. Division II grand final of the Central Regional. They come out to the near side, can't get it. He had to get the ball clear, and he did. Jortner goes up high, punched away. And now digging onto it. I think he might have pulled something. Or that was his poor attempt at skipping. And the ball gets batted out of bounds. I thought he may have pulled something.
No, he was definitely trying to do the shimmy. Left, right, left, right.
That, left, right, up, down, A, B, start.
I think anyone he actually might have thought it was himself.
Yes. I mean, it's sort of like, what are you, well, that'll be a new dance of some sort. So,
Whatever it takes to go viral, Brian.
Yep. I'm sure I'll find a way at some point. Anyway, Miller tried to get it forward for Dallas. Columbus picks it back into the middle. It's all out there open. Epperson couldn't get to it. He just got a toe to it. Dallas maintains possession. Epperson throws a Shepherd. And they kick it out to Storer, who is wide open. Storer's going to go back, take a couple of seconds. He's not going to have too long. Now he chips it up over the top. The pack forms, and it's taken there by 22. It's kicked for goal, and it has gone off for another minor score. So Dallas having the precision of play right now, but again, not too much in the results category. They go to 1-4-10, Columbus one behind. 7.5 minutes to go opening term. And that's holding the ball, and it'll be a free kick for Dallas.
Certainly controlling all the play here at the moment.
Yep.
Columbus having a hard time getting the ball out of the back line.
Yep. And they've only made that one foray really into inside 50. Here's the kick. It's a booming kick. Oh my. Behind. It's still a very good kick. A for effort. Dallas goes to 1-5-11. It's a 10-point lead on the Real Racine scoreboard. Columbus 1 point. They go up on that far sideline. Yep, kick up high. It comes to Ben Markham. Markham looking for somebody to handball to. Now he just throws it onto the left boot. It's paddled forward by 27, that's Chad Welday, and they keep it. They kick that one forward, not anybody there in the forward line for Columbus, and then they kick it out into the cow paddock to the near side. It's picked up by Odell. Jack Odell kicks that one long. It's a 2-on-1 for Columbus. He just got his hand to it. Jortner's back there for Dallas, but in the end it's Ramo, and Ramo gets the ball off. All alone is the number 11, that's Alec Dooley, and Dooley will assess what he has. Now he'll go short, but the kick was not a very good one. He was looking for McClure there, and McClure will get the handball back. Now pump that one forward, but again, no numbers for the Jackaroos, and Dallas will claim it. That one is smothered by Simpson. And then he gets tackled here, just got the ball away, and picked up and kicked by Tyson Harding. Or check that, that's looking at the wrong side. That's Matt Beagley. They still ushering it forward, or Columbus Moonter just tried to soccer it. That was a karate sidekick.
And a third one.
Yep. Oh, good job there by Jay Karutz. Karutz. Who bumped off his man and took the mark. He's probably about two kicks from goal. Maybe not. Maybe not. Nope, batted down there. It's loose out in front. It's claimed by, thought that was Storer for a second. Odell is in there. They may have been kicking in danger, and then being claimed there as the number two for Dylan Hamilton for Columbus. The rain's starting to pick up a little bit more here in Racine. And handballs it back. And the mark is almost, and in fact it was taken. Storer now up that right side. And the mark also is taken. So a cup, stringing a couple of those together. And he's going to play on. He sold a little bit of candy. Now kicks that one out into the middle. And the mark is taken by number 11. That is Ryan Epperson. That's the other Epperson. We've called Derek's name a little bit more. But Ryan Epperson now, he's about 70 meters from goal. It's a long, low kick. And it's deflected. They have it. They kick it towards goal. But in the end, it's Andy Brandis who's back there. I thought that was Ramo. They're both wearing headbands, but it's Brandis. And now Ridenour tries to get the ball past the ball. It's not clean. Miller kicks that one for goal. It's knocked down by the forward. And then he slides on through, but it's touched.
Quite some play soccer skills there, but wasn't caught afterward.
Yep. Hurry, run. 1-6-12 for Dallas. And one behind still for Columbus. The whole idea of soccering the ball, while a good idea, it needs to be high percentage or don't bother. But that's just my opinion, and I speak as somebody who soccered the ball a lot during my time in the league. Free kick to Dallas on that far side. And I believe that was Timothy Zorka, number 19, who was sin-binned. He's still on the sideline over there on the forward line. So they've stuck somebody else there. Out of the ruck, Columbus controls it. And it's squirted along, and it's going to go out of bounds. You can tell the grass is getting a little bit wetter. That ball just died after it rolled maybe about 2 feet. So a throw in. Ryan Barish alongside Dennis Ryan here. The Division II USAFL Central Championship match between Dallas and Columbus. Here's Miller up on that far side. He had a bounce or a hand pass, and then that one is kicked out. Dooley was over there for Columbus, and then kicked back up high. Not for anybody, really. John Dobbs over there for Dallas. And now it's pumped back inside, and it's gone out on the full. Yep. Columbus taking down Tulsa and the Milwaukee-Indianapolis combination in their pool play matches. Dallas defeated Des Moines and Ohio Valley to get to this one. They continue that one on. A good mark there. They play that on. It rolls through. That one's paddle. That could have been a throw. Storer in there with a tackle. And they just get it off to the Jacks. They kick that one inside. Moonter able to get, trying to get to it. He paddles it onto himself. Look at him go. He looks like Plugger Jr., doesn't he? He goes in there. It's picked up by 18. That is Tom Matthew. Matthew squibs it through, but it's collected by the Dallas defense. And now they'll kick that one out. It's a high kick. It'll bring rain, bring more rain. It's tipped down, picked up by Peterson with Simpson in support. Now he kicks it through. It's Sleeper who kicks it long for Columbus, but to whom was that? Nobody knows. And Dallas controls it and goes back the other way. It's tipped again. And now up on that far side, it's up in the air, and the mark is taken nicely by number 13 for Dallas. And this is going to be a kick after the siren as time is gone here in the first half. So Jackaroos sending all their players back. They want to be careful and make sure nobody comes over the mark. So here's the kick on the way. It's going to be short. And that'll be the way the first half ends. Both teams with pretty spirited play, but Dallas has gotten the better of the scoring opportunities. And they haven't made Columbus play. It's still very much a close game at halftime, the score. The Dallas Magpies, 1-6 behind, 12 points. The Columbus Jackaroos, 1 behind, 1 point total. We'll be back for the second half of this Division II Grand Final when we return to this one on USAFL.com. Second half of this one about to get underway, with Dallas leading 12-1. It's 12-1. We were double checking the score here at halftime, but Columbus still only 11 points down. As Simpson kicks that one up, he was looking for McClure again. There's the handball out of the back, looking for Markham. And now on through, or rather a sleeper. Oh, that's got to be in the back, and it is. Yes. And it'll be a free kick to Columbus.
Sorry for the jerky camera work there. I'm trying to hold the camera and an umbrella in the same hand so I don't get the camera wet.
And at the same time, avoid carpal tunnel syndrome. That kick was for Simpson. It was on a hop. Simpson will eventually pick it up. He gets away. Just had to get the handball off under duress. And that's got to be a throw, or high tackle. Well, that was pick your poison on that one. So it's still 12-1 Dallas with Chet Ridenour, the coach of the Columbus Jackaroos, a very, very spirited halftime speech. Let's see what it does. Dallas has possession through Jack Odell. Odell with a kick long. Markham can't get to it, but it's on now. They kick that one in towards. It's a mark, and he's going to run on. It's going to be Zorko. And a great job by Corey Colvin to get the ball to Zorko. And it takes Dallas to 2-6-18, and that extends their lead to 17 points on the Real Racine scoreboard. Well, Zorka, who is sin-binned for some sort of infraction, I'm guessing it may have been back chat.
The play, I saw the Columbus player getting up off the ground, so he obviously threw him to the ground.
Or yeah.
Some other way, forcibly.
Yep. Oh, got right to him. And with it now is Harding. Oh, good shepherd in there trying to get the ball away. And in the end, it's a tie-up, and we'll have a ball up. The ball goes back up in the air. Punch forward again by 22. And then swatted at it. Everyone just swatting at the ball. No one actually trying to get it. But in the end, it's big. Bigley, it's smothered again, picked up by, I didn't see who it was, but it's out of bounds. Oh, it was Stephen Ramo right there. Stephen Ramo has been around this club a long time too. In fact, they've earned a free kick. No, it's going to be a throw-in. Yeah, so we're without boundary umpires for this match. So what's happening here is that one player throws the ball in, and so that it's even, because it would be an even player situation. Normally, if there was a boundary umpire, another player goes out to equilibrate the situation. Columbus trying to get the ball out of their own back territory. And it's Zorka again, but again, Columbus stands tall. And now they have some room through Simpson. Simpson comes up to the near side, and the mark is taken there nicely by number one. That is Jay Karutz. And Karutz now, and over the, no, initially thought they were going to play 50. Karutz's kick, it's a long kick. Oh, crash, boom, opera, and nobody got it. And in the end, it rolls over the line and out of bounds. 18-1 the score. opening minutes, second half of this Central Regional Division II National Championship. We have the Division I coming up with New York and Austin not too long after this one. It's a high tackle. Oh, well. Whoops. Will they? No, they're going to say it was... No, they're going to say it was out on the full. Yeah, he was out on the full. Out of the full and then a 50 for delay. Yeah, that's Brandon Crow, who's our umpire out there, and Tyson Harding will take the free kick. Into the middle, Miller was there, almost grabbed by 22.
It actually might have been 25 because 25 might be our penalty.
Yeah.
Brian, I'm not sure.
I think it is. I think it, technically it's a 25 in anything other than Division One at Nationals. That's holding the ball and a free kick for Columbus. Columbus is digging in for the most part, or trying to anyway. The kick's out to Karutz, who takes the mark.
Yep. They
need to dig up.
There's some flair and taking risks because they've got to get, obviously, get some scores.
Anish Mystery was in there, and they get the handball off to McClure. Tried to find Mystery again, but couldn't. Short kick over the top for Colvin. Colvin's going to run up the side, makes a call, kicks a wounded duck into the middle. It bounces over the head of Ridenour, who finally corrals it. And now he kicks it out to the right side. The mark is not taken, left on the carpet. And then it's scrambled free. Picked up by Brandis on that far side. Play on, says the umpire. May have been taken down without the ball. Play on again. Storer picks it up for Dallas. He paddles it forward. Takes the man off the ball, but not taken down. And then he takes down the Columbus player over there. That's 18, which would be Tom Matthew. So a ball up again directly across from a second half action, 18-1. The Dallas Magpies, your leader. They're the number 7 team in the country. Columbus is number 13. He holds them up. Still held up over there. Now it's rushed forward. Miller, still over there, paddles it on the ground. They give the ball back. It's high tackle. Yep. And that's Jack O'Dell, and it was Ridenour, and Ridenour immediately went down and told Jack that, you know, it was an accident, it wasn't on purpose. Went to grab him, and O'Dell, I think, ducked a little bit.
I think it was a sloppy tackle from Chet.
Yeah.
He grabbed him high, and then he slung him.
We'll of course, be giving him some nonsense about that.
The ground is very, very hard. It looks lush and green here, but certainly that clay-based soil here is very rough hard at the moment.
O'Dell's free kick. Looks good. And is good. So Jack O'Dell has given his team a 23-point lead on the Real Racine scoreboard. Dallas 3-6-24. Columbus one behind, 1 point. And The Magpie is starting to flex their muscles a little bit as the rain continues to come down a little bit harder. How's your umbrella holding up there, Dennis?
It's getting a little sore.
Yeah.
Trying to hold that and the camera in the same end.
The ball is kicked forward and Dallas contains it and they send it back. It's a long kick looking for Storr, but Ridenour sneaks up and takes the mark in the center square. He's going to go short. And the mark is taken over there by, I believe that was McClure again. The kick inside 50, looking in the Simpson direction. It's over and they play on. And they kick Preet going after it and the ball goes out of bounds. That's Phil Preet. And in there is Ryan Munter, the Australian. It has. It's a little, it's getting a little windy. But you know what? Like I said, the sky is generally blue. There's some light cloud cover. There's no indication, and I'm no meteorologist, there's no indication that the weather is going to pick up anymore. You see the New York Magpies in the background there getting ready for their game. and it's a tackle, and it'll be a ball up. And a whistle, and it's going to be a 50. Well,
25, I think it's a free kick in it for abuse.
Yep, free kick for dissent, as they say in soccer. 11 minutes to go in this one, 24-1 in favor of the Dallas Magpies. Nice mark, and then he's hold down afterwards. And Ridenour comes in immediately to play peacemaker, as so did Bren Miller as well. And they're saying they had crossed the mark, but they hadn't. The kick is over to Ridenour. Ridenour looking around. He's got a couple of players calling for him. Kicks it out on that far sideline, looking for McClure. Kept in by Dallas and then cleared out by the Magpie back line. It bounces in front of Miller and Ridenour. Markham was in there for Columbus. Miller gets it back again. It's still on that far sideline. And it's picked up by the Jacks. There's a low kick. And it's marked defensively by that fullback for the Dallas Magpies. Rain picking up a little more. Kicked out to the near side now. Up in the air, Simpson camps himself under it and makes a can of corn catch. He's gonna go across and the mark is taken. And I believe that is number one, which is Jay Karutz. And Jay, apologize if I'm mangling your name here. You won't be the first, I assure you. Karutz's kick. Oh, beautiful kick, but wide. Second point of the game for Columbus. The lead is back to 24-2 now, with 9 minutes to go in the ball game. So it's a short kick out of the back. They go for a kick up on the side, and the mark is taken by Mike Main. Main. Oh, good job by Ridenour to step up and spoil it, but he is quickly dispossessed. And it's Dylan Braun who's over there, and the ball will go out of bounds again. 8 minutes to go. Still a 24-2 lead. Ball comes back into play. Storer is over there. Can't get it forward. Now it's soccered on by the Magpies. Call for a high tackle is ignored. Simpson with his left foot, but that one is picked off by Storer. Storer with two bounces. Storer runs to the top of the 50 and finds Timothy Zorka all by himself. And he's going to handball the ball over the top. Storer was running on and he's going to kick the goal. Great job of running on and a great job of separation by Zorka to set that up. And that
almost going to make a meal of it there as he ended up kicking the ball off the ground in the goal square. But.
Yeah, and in this weather, you know, you just sort of have to take the opportunity. So 4-6-30 for Dallas, two behinds with 7 minutes to go in the ball game. Knocked forward by Dallas. Odell is over there. It's a whistle and a free kick. And it goes to Dallas. Long kick. Through the hands of the defender, Zorka comes in to try and swat it away. Mystery has it for Columbus, and now it's scooped up as Peterson had it, and now it's Ridenour. Ridenour looking for some help on that far sideline. But it's picked up as Odell is over there. He tried to stick his hand in. McClure's bumped off the ball heavily. And now there's a team meeting over there and we'll have a ball up. Still have one more game after this to bring you. The New York Magpies and the Austin Crows in the Division I championship immediately after this one. They handball it up over the top. And they get it away. Looking for Odell, but it's Simpson who's so fast. Not a very good kick from Simpson as it was straight up in the air. And taking the mark on a hop there was Mike Main. You could see Simpson as he went to kick. It snapped his foot. Not the best of drops, but we'll excuse him because he normally is pretty good. Long kick out to the near side looking for Storr. Instead, it pops to Preet. Preet goes back inside 50. It takes a hop up over the head, and it's cleared out of the back, controlled out of the back. It's Odell, who I didn't realize was going to play that far back, and it's marked up on that far side. Trying to catch the young man's number over there. Kick is on the way. It looks good. And they needed that. A goal for Joel Busack. And that is very, very helpful. But they're going to need some more of that, and they're going to need that quickly. 5 minutes to go. Dallas 4-6-30. Columbus 1-2-8. They got one back. They're going to need another one, and they're going to need them in a hurry. The ball comes back into the center of the ground. It's getting colder and getting windier here. This is now a complete opposite of what it was in Sacramento, Dennis.
2 weeks and 1,500 miles.
Yep. And here comes Dallas trying to answer. The kick is towards Zorka. Zorka can't handle it cleanly, but he paddles it on to someone who maybe can. And they finally get it. That was Andy Brandis for Columbus, and the ball is kicked out. Up over the top, it's paddled forward by 22. That's Munter, the Australian. And now it's a good shepherd as they kick that one in. It's a two-on-two contest onto the full forward. He's knocked down off the ball. Mean, but he can't get a good kick. It's a chance. And it's out on the full, in point of fact. Well, that was a golden opportunity for the Jacks right there, but unable to get anything from it. So Odell will put the ball back into play with about 4 minutes or so, we'll say 3.5 to go in the ball game. Odell goes short, and instead he finds Columbus's Philip Preet, who's played very well. Preet fancying himself here. The kick is for goal. It's straight. Does it have the distance? Yes, it does. Yeah. Philip Preet with a great goal. Well, they have 3 minutes, and it's a 16-point game, 30-14 now. I've seen stranger things happen in footy, Dennis, but they're going to have to really full the throttle on. And I think if I'm Dallas, I'm putting more people behind the ball, and I think that's the case. I'm only counting four in the forward line. And I guess you can't really do the opposite if you're Columbus. That one is punched forward, but right at Ridenour, who gets the ball away quickly, probably should have taken his time. It's soccered on by Colvin, and that's got to be a throw before the high tackle. That could have been either or. Here's the kick. It's up high. Oh, nice mark taken by Jortner. 1-on-2. As he was able to get it over Ramo and also Ridenour. Jortner's kick had a little bit of English on it. Almost taken down. And that's got to be a high tackle, and it is on Storr. Storr wasn't happy with the call, but it was the correct one. Out to the far side, and the mark taken again by Kurutz. They got to go forward. They got to push here, looking for Simpson over the back, but he couldn't get to him. The ball rolls free. It's picked up by Epperson, who handballs it over the top to Jortner. Jortner bootlegs around to sell some candy. Long kick. And it's marked defensively by an uncontested Chet Ridenour, who goes out to the far side. You gotta go, son, gotta go. Karutz now, he's gotta find somebody, gotta do it in a hurry. Long kick up to right side, looking for McClure, not finding him, and the ball will find the boundary line eventually, yes. Not much time to go, and I think the mountain may be too steep here for Columbus, but they have had a very good day of football. 45 seconds unofficially to go. Yep. Kicked forward again, and again Dallas trying to salt this one away. It skips by Asa Potter. And now Columbus trying to move it forward, trying to do, trying to get something there at the end. But it's kicked and it's out of bounds. Final seconds of this one ebbing away, and the Dallas Magpies. In fact, there it is. That is the final. That is the final whistle, and the Dallas Magpies are your 2015 USAFL Central Regional Division II champions. They have done so in pretty decent fashion here, taking out a very game Columbus Jackaroos side by 16 points. Final score lines read: the Dallas Magpies 4 goals, 6 behinds, 30 points. The Columbus Jackaroos 2 goals, 2 behinds, 14 points. Don't go anywhere, folks. We have one more game left, the Division I National Division I Regional Championship between Austin and New York. We'll have that for you in just a little bit. You're watching the 2015 Central Regional from Racine, Wisconsin, here on USAFL.com.